ODI 100 for England as captain as well. It's a real important moment, a milestone. She's led from the front.
First game of the series, the Aussies had put on about 360-odd and we'd lost five or six quick wickets, staring down the barrel a little bit. I'm quite relaxed, actually. I felt in a really good place for my game. I felt like I'd known my game really well by that point in my career. Got together with Laura Marsh, put on a really good partnership. Got 157, first ever 100 for England, first time I'd raised the helmet and the bat. Just quite nervous about obviously wanting to get my first 100 and yeah, managed to do it, which was really nice. Mark Robinson had just taken over. I was batting in the middle order. It was a little bit of a slow wicket at the Bullring in Joburg. And it was one of the first times I'd really made a big contribution in the middle order, really shepherded an innings, made sure we chased down the total. And yeah, it felt like I really owned that role in the middle order and yeah, delighted that we managed to win that game. Improved my game against spin, and I think on that sort of wicket and being able to really soak up the pressure and having that innings gave me confidence to do that for England moving forward. I'd had to work a lot in my T20 game throughout the years and really had put a lot of work in before this game and had a really good build-up in terms of T20 prep, and it was the first innings where I felt like I really dominated a T20. I was batting at 3 for Western Storm, and the game was down at Taunton, and I got 97 against Yorkshire Diamonds. Felt like I could really have the skill set and the game to take bowlers on in T20. It was just an enactment of all the work that I'd done in T20, trying to score 360, trying to score a lot quicker and take bowlers down. So that innings was really proof for me that the work had been worth it and I could play T20 cricket and dominate in it.